Hi, hello, good morning children. Once again, welcome to my maths class. This is Srinivas from ZPHS Dabalpur. You may be knowing, that's okay. So far we have been learning, we have been discussing about circles in our 9th class mathematics chapter. So today also let us continue to learn that one with a new concept. That concept today I am going to explain you. Please listen carefully, children, and try to do the homework which I have given to you as worksheets. Have you all completed the worksheets in previous sessions? I have given two worksheets in the previous sessions. So this is the next worksheet you are going to have. So try to solve it. If you don't know, if you don't understand, if you didn't get the answer, try to get clarified with your class maths teacher. Okay, children, that's good. I hope you are following. You will be following. Thank you. Thank you so much. So let us go to the next concept in our circles chapter is like this. See, equal chords of a circle sustains equal angles at the center. Equal chords of a circle subtends equal angles at the center. See, in the previous session we have learned the angle subtends by a chord at the center and on a point on the circle, a point on the circle. But here it is equal chords of a circle subtends equal angles at the center. What do you mean by equal chords? Already we have learned in previous session about chords and angles. Chords increases, then angle at the center increases, isn't it? If the chords decreases, angle at the center is decreases. Now if the chords are equal, see, observe, this is a circle. Okay, this is a circle. Now A is a point, B is a point, join these two. Now you get a chord. This is a chord. This chord makes an equal angle. Sorry, this chord makes an angle at the center. If chord length is increases, then the angle also increases. That is what we have learnt in the previous sessions, isn't it? But it is not like that. Equal chords, if the length of the chord increases, angle subtends at the center also increases. If the length of the chord decreases, angle subtends at the center also decreases. But here the lengths are same, equal chords. Now what happened? You may be knowing now. Already you can understand. Can you say? If the length increases, angle increases. If the length of the chord decreases, angle decreases. If the length of the chords are equal, angles also? Yes, that's good. Now I am going to explain you with the representation. Listen carefully. Now take another two points on the circle and join this one. This is CD is a chord, AB is a chord. The length of this AB is 5 centimeters. Length of another chord CD is 5 centimeter. So both the chords are of same length. That means equal chords. See, equal chords. So I have taken equal chords. Now we have to see what is the angle at the center. So take join AO and OB. Now this angle we have to compare with this angle. Join CO and DO. CO and DO. So O be the center. AB and CD are two equal chords. See, equal chords of a circle subtends equal angles at the center. So we need to prove that this angle and this angle, these two angles are equal. it is given equal chords, we have to prove equal angles. So that is why, let us prove. In proof, we will be having like this given, RTP, proof and all. So let me explain one by one. First of all, we have to write what is given. See, I'll tell you, first statement will be given. According to that, we have to draw a diagram. This is a theorem. Okay, we have to draw a diagram. And then the first one is given. We have to write what is given. What is given? Equal chords of a circle, that is given. This is what we have to prove. This statement is two parts. First one is given, second one is conclusion. This given is equal chords of a circle. What is a circle? A circle is a circle with center O. So O be the center. And what are the chords? A, B and C, D are the chords. Two equal chords. Okay, this is given in the statement. Now, what we have to prove? RTP, required to prove. This is the meaning of RTP. Required to prove. What we have to prove? This angle, that is AOB, that is the representation. Angle AOB, this is the representation of angle, is equal to this angle, that is angle COD. This is what we have to prove. That is required to prove. Angle AOB is equal to angle COD. Let us prove it. Let us take proof. So how to prove? In triangle AOB and COD, see, there are two triangles, AOB. This is a triangle, and COD. This is a triangle. Now there are two triangles. So in these two triangles, we can observe some points. What are those points? To prove this one, see, this is what we have to prove. To prove this, we should go in steps. These two are two triangles. I can observe AB is equal to CD only, no? Because both are equal chords, that is given. So that is the first point, AB is equal to CD. It is given. Why it is given? Equal chords. What are those chords? AB and CD. See, AB and CD. 5 centimeter, 5 centimeter. So equal. So the next one, OA is equal to OC. Why these two are equal? OA, from center to a point on the circle, it is called radius. In the same way, OC also radius. So OA is equal to OC, that is radii. When we write in plural, we will write radii. That means both are radius. This is one radius and this is one radii. Radius always equal in a same circle, no? That is why OA is equal to OC. Okay, the next one, OB is equal to OD. OB, that is radius. OD, that is also radius. Since these two are again radii, those are equal. See, now what can we understand here? This is triangle ABO or AOB. Now, this is triangle AOB and this is triangle COD. Okay. In these two triangles, this AB side is equal to CD side, OA side is equal to OC side, OB side is equal to OD side. That means all the three sides of one triangle equal to all the three sides of another triangle. Now you may be recalling, what is this? Three sides of one triangle are equal to the corresponding sides of another triangle. This is some rule. What is that rule? Congruent rule. So triangle AOB is congruent to triangle COD. This is congruent rule. By SSS rule, these two triangles are congruent. If these two triangles are congruent, then automatically these two angles are equal. Why? Because if all the sides are equal, then all the angles also, corresponding angles also equal. So we can say that these two angles are equal. Yes or no? So corresponding angles. What are those corresponding angles? Angle AOB and angle COD. So angle AOB, that is this angle, equal to angle COD, that is this angle. So both are equal. So corresponding angles are equal. That's what we have to prove, no? Equal chords of a circle subtends equal angles. Yes, angle AOB is equal to angle COD. Yes, we got it. Angle AOB is equal to angle COD. So if the chords are equal, if there are equal chords, then it makes equal angles at the center. So this chord and this chord, AB is equal to CD, then this angle is equal to this angle. For example, this angle is 100, then this angle also 100 only. We can say in converse, if the angles are equal, then the chords also equal. Like that also we can say. Okay children, I hope you understood very well. This is a theorem which is in your textbook. I explained, I hope you understood well. Thank you. Okay, let us go for the worksheet. See, what is a worksheet? Here, this is exercise 12.2, which is in your textbook. There are two problems. Two sums are given, three. Now, first problem, this sum I will just explain. Okay, I don't write, just I will explain, that's all. Then you can do the remaining two. See the first question, in the figure, this is the figure. AB is equal to CD. AB is equal to CD. That means we can understand AB is a chord, CD is a chord. So chords are equal. That's what it is given. And another one is given. Angle AOB is 90 degree. I'll show you what is angle AOB. AOB. That means this angle is 90. Then find angle COD. COD. That means this angle we have to find out. If this is 90, then this one, yes, it is also 90. Why? Because AB and CD are equal chords. Here it is given, AB is equal to CD. So if this angle AOB is 90 degree, then angle COD also 90 degree only. So just you can write here very easy. Angle COD is equal to 90 degree since chords are equal. Then the angle subtended by the chords at the center also equal. That's what you have to write. Over. This is the first question. Like that, take second question and third question. You will understand very easily. If you don't understand, get clarified from your class maths teacher. Surely you have to go and clarify from your maths teacher. Otherwise, you can give me a mail. I'll clarify. Thank you. Thank you so much, dear students. I hope you understood very well so far the circles chapter. Okay? I hope you understood very well. So many, many concepts we have learnt in the chapter circles. Thank you for listening very properly and interestingly you are listening. Thank you so much. I appreciate your interest. Okay? Thank you. Keep watching. This is Srinivas. Once again, let us meet. Thank you. Thank you one and all. Bye.